fit.
Rubik, make sure that your phones are on silent. You do not disturb.
I don't think my phone has silent.
Good job.
Holly.
Everyone, please rise.
Mother and I.
Y'all can be seated.
Sarah and Jessie are here today to be joined in marriage. This is much more than a social and civil occasion. It is a declaration of your hearts, built upon experience, friendship, and enriched by your love. With love, it is possible to live life together, each seeking and encouraging the joy and comfort and health for each other, all of which will divide sorrow and multiply satisfactions. Real love in marriage is something beyond the warmth and the excitement of romance, of being deeply in love. It is as much about the welfare and happiness of your marriage partner as about your own. But real love is not being absorbed in each other. Love makes burdens lighter because you divide them. It makes joys more intense because you share them. It makes you stronger so that you can reach out and become involved in life in ways you dare not risk alone. True marriage is more than joining the bonds of marriage of two persons. It is a union of two hearts. It thrives on the love you give each other, and it never grows old. But it prospers on the joy of each new day. Marriage is love. May you always be able to talk things over, to confide in each other, to laugh with each other, and to enjoy life together. May you be blessed with a lifetime of happiness and a home of warmth and understanding. In acknowledgement of his holy purpose and of the power of this occasion, let us bow our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, as we come to your throne of grace, mercy, and love, I ask that you bless the union of marriage between Sarah and Jessie. May they go forward as one soul and one spirit, including their respective families. Bless them this day. Oh, and Father, please, I ask that you especially bless one of our dear friends who is in need. Our dear friend, Feathers. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Sarah and Jessie are here to marry each other. No one else can create such a union. It is their words, their intentions, their vision that must define and shape this marriage. So I call upon them now to state their promises before this group, the pledges that will bind them together.
Do I still gotta go first?
You don't have to.
All right. Before you, I was broken. After I found you, I realized that my life before you would never again make me happy. Within your eyes, I now see love that I never knew. All right, I screwed up all of One Tree Hill. I just gotta stop. That's about as much as Brooke and Julian you get. So, I promised your father when I asked him for you that you would never want, you would never need. I promised that I would love your annoying sister as much as I never wanted to. I wish I could promise you the world, but it's not mine to give. Instead, I'll give you my world and all that comes with it. My children, my heart, my soul. I wish I could promise you riches, but I can't promise you things that I can't have in the future. So instead, I promise you everything that's intangible that I could possibly give you. The width of my shoulders, the strength of my back, the length of my knees, and I'll hold you when you're weak. I wish I could tell you I'd never hurt you, but I'm human, and I will falter. So instead, I will promise the words and the love that you have taught me to give back to you in the words that I'm sorry, and I apologize. I promise to be this well-behaved, trained puppy that you've taught me to be.
My old dog.
With these words, I love you. And if you will please say yes, I won't have to live without you.
Well, man, I wrote mine down. I have pockets.
The hell? Is it one page?
Just one page. Jessie, before you, I always felt like a lost soul who was searching for something, and I never could figure out exactly what I was searching for. And then I walked into your office, and we had all those odds stacked against us from the beginning. But I never was so sure of anything like I was you. Whenever I'm with you, wherever we are, I feel like home. You're my rock, my biggest fan, my happy place, and the best friend I've ever had. I promise to always love you and cherish you for everything you are and everything you grow to be. I promise to always stand by your side in whatever you set out to do. I promise to always love and support Katavina and Christian. And I promise I'll never take for granted the most beautiful gifts you brought into my life the day I met them. I promise to always put our family first. I promise to always be up for our spontaneous adventures. I promise I'll do my best not to gasp every 2 minutes when you drive. I promise to love you in sickness and health, through the smiles and the tears, through the laugh and the silence. I promise I'll never take for granted all the millions of little things you do just to make me smile. Jess, you've made all my dreams come true. You give me the greatest family in the world, and you push me to accomplish things I never thought I could. You've made me believe in things I never knew were even possible. And now in just a few minutes, I get to marry my dream guy. I promise to prove all these vows true with small acts of devotion every day and love you until my very last breath.
Yours weren't supposed to be longer than mine.
Sarah and Jessie, you are about to make promises to one another. These vows are words representing your intentions. You will find that as you live your lives by these vows, investing your time and love and your commitment to each other, the happy times of your life will be twice as joyous because there will be someone that will share those joys within this marriage. Jessie, will you take Sarah to be your lawful wife, to love her, honor her, keep her in sickness and in good health, forsaking all others and keeping only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Sarah, will you take Jessie to be your lawful husband, to love him, honor him, keep him in sickness and in good health, forsaking all others and keeping only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
You got the ring pop?
I hope so.
Wedding rings are made precious because you wear them. Your rings say that even in your individuality, you have chosen to be together. Let these rings be a sign that love has substance as well as a soul, a present as well as a past, and that despite its occasional burdens, love is a circle of happiness, wonder, and delight. May these rings remind you always of the vows you have taken here today. And place this ring on Sarah's finger. Repeat after me. With this ring,
I thee wed.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
This day.
And forevermore.
And forevermore.
Sarah and place the ring on Jesse's finger. Repeat after me. One of the best joys of life is making sure it's the right one. With this ring, I thee wed. With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you. This day. And forevermore. Sarah and Jesse have chosen to include this wine box and letter ceremony in today's proceedings. So come join me. Like a good wine, a great love will deepen and mature with age. This is our hope as both Sarah and Jesse have taken the time to compose a letter addressed to each other. Inside are heartfelt words describing their feelings, aspirations for their future, and reasons why they have chosen to marry each other. The letters have been sealed, and in this case, with love. And neither has seen what the other have written. These letters will encapsulate the romance and sense of hope that they are both feeling at this special time in the relationship. Let me close it. Sarah and Jesse, do you promise to respect and honor the commitments you have made here today and through kindness and compassion achieve the life you have planned together?
I do.
They will reopen and enjoy the contents of this box on the occasion of their fifth anniversary. There is only one other time that you may open this box and partake of its contents. If at some point in the future your relationship falters and you feel like you have lost your way, sit down and take a couple of drinks. Read the letters that you've written to each other and be memorable of this day that you're partaking in. And hopefully that will bring you back to the moment and make you forget what you're fighting about and whatever made you lose your love for the moment. And it will rekindle that love. And all you have to do then, at that point, once you finish the bottle and finish the letters, is rewrite some more letters and put in another bottle and put it back on the shelf and wait 5 more years. Rinse and repeat.
She don't forget. This gift keeps giving.
It is my sincere hope that these here today that have witnessed the ceremony, that the romantic sentiments of words and commitments you have written to one another will always serve as a gift beyond measure. May they always remind you of the love that you have for each other, maybe at the 5th or the 50th year of your marriage. Sarah and Jesse, from this day forward, your lives will be woven of one design. Your perils and your joys shall not be known apart. As you increase in love and understanding, may your joy stand victoriously against the storm of circumstance that beats impartially on all of our doors. From the rich encouragement of your affection, may you be inspired to open the doors to the needs you perceive in the world. In the embrace of mutual respect, may you each complete the unfinished pattern of your true selves. You've made special promises to one another, which have been symbolized by the joining of hands, the taking of vows, and the giving and receiving of rings. By the authority vested in me by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. It is with great pride and privilege I announce for the first time to the world, Mr. and Mrs. Wallace. Hey. Everyone is now welcome to join us for cocktails in the big barn, and we're going to take pictures with all the family. Thank you.